So homeopathy and pseudo homeopathy. Nowadays, so many homeopaths are struggling to get proper results as well as the proper explanations to the critics and skeptics, because so many scientists and so many other critics may ask the questions: how does homeopathy works? How you select remedies? Why you are not success in all the cases? Sometimes you get success, sometimes you not. And some other questions those persons though don't believe in homeopathy, but they get accidental results from homeopath too. And most of the homeopath believes in homeopathy, they can successfully treated the so many patients in their practice, very critical patients, very non-curable cases, those they are very much tired because of due to some other allopathic modes of treatment, and after they treated with the homeopathy, they get a very good dramatic results. That's why so many homeopaths are struggling to understand what actually the homeopathy is. So in today's session, I want to clear all about this, because in homeopathy there are two drastic differences are there, or two streams are there: a homeopathy and pseudo homeopathy. Homeopathy is mostly discovered by Hahnemannian way of thinking, and most of the principles that he discovered are not followed by pseudo homeopaths. There are lots of own interpretations of his aphorisms, and own explanations, own theories are to be added into the homeopathic streams. For example, like a batch flower remedy are not at all homeopathic. The 12 tissue remedies are again not at all homeopathy, or most of the treatments are prescribed only on the basis of behavioral patterns or mind patterns, or so many psychosomatic theories are applied into the homeopathic way of principle. But homeopathy is not at all like that. Hahnemann homeopathy is very different. It is a scientific way of practice based on mathematics, based on the scientific laws, and whatever the master's teachings are there are nowadays not in actual practice. Only few of the homeopaths are just understand about it, and they are practicing on Hahnemannian homeopathy. But though today's homeopaths are far away from Hahnemannian homeopathy, that's why they are struggling. So I want to make it clear that if you want to practice homeopathy confidently, very successfully, and very standardized way, authentic way, mathematical way, that if you are treating 10 patients, approximately you are able to treat successfully 80% patients very confidently, as allopath do, or allopath palliate their cases in their ways of treatments. We have a very much scientific data in Hahnemannian literature, but unfortunately most of the homeopaths are not following it, or some of the homeopaths intermingling the thoughts of pseudo homeopathy with the homeopathy, Hahnemannian homeopathy. That's why all these problems are created in the homeopathy. So what are the your main important issues that you are intermingling the Hahnemannian homeopathy with other homeopathy? So number one and first important issue is that Hahnemannian miasms are far different from nowadays the people are thinking about. Second important thing is a potency that master is in his last 6th edition discovered the LM potency, because this is the important discovery of Master Hahnemann. Unless and until you can't apply the correct dose and correct potency, you can't get better results. So that is the main important difference in the homeopath, Hahnemannian homeopath and pseudo homeopath mostly. And third important aspect is the understanding of symptomatology through the Hahnemannian way, pathogenesis of a patient as well as the remedy in a Hahnemannian way. And nowadays the most of the homeopath that mixing with the mental pictures, the behaviors, and so many rubrics, repertorial languages, all these three things mostly getting so many obstacles to understanding the homeopathy, as well as incorrect and haphazard prescriptions or repetition of dose or wrong changing of remedies without understanding the correct follow-up. So that's why most of the homeopaths are struggling to get a successful results. So lastly, I want to tell you that if you want to become a successful scientific homeopath, as I always said, not I, but Master Hanuman also said that. So those homeopaths who are following the Hanumanian teachings genuinely, he called them as a genuine practical homeopath. If you want to become a genuine practical homeopath, please follow the Hanumanian techniques. And if you feel this video is helpful for you, please share with your friends. Thank you.